Dignus es agnus qui occisus est, accipire virtutem et divinitatem et sapientiam et fortitudinem et honorem, ipsi gloria imperium in saecula saeculorum.
How worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and divinity and wisdom and strength and honor. To him belong glory and power forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, good morning. You're very welcome to St. Raphael as we gather now on this beautiful feast, the solemnity of Jesus Christ, King of the universe, Christ the King, to enter into the mystery of his presence among us. It's great to have the Prévost boys with me on the altar. They always do a great job, even though I had to send them down to the seats to the east of me, I guess. Just to explain one thing, we're going to be trying to chant the introit. The introit is that scriptural verse that begins every Mass. So after the gathering song, the opening song that you've just finished, there will be, as we move along in the liturgy, the chanting of this either in Latin or in English, or as today in both languages. A beautiful reminder to us that Latin is part of our heritage as Christians of the Roman Rite, and also brings a bit of musicality to our Mass. So with that, let us pause, reflect, and consider the many ways we have turned away from Christ the King. We have failed him. He never fails us. And so we ask for his pardon and his healing grace. Lord Jesus, you are servant and King of all ages, we pray. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the source of life and hope. We pray, Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the love of the eternal Father poured forth into our world. We pray, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. We will do the Gloria, if I can find it and remember it.
Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus, bonae voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratias agimus tibi, propter magnam gloriam tuam. Domine Deus, Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Filii Unigenite, Iesu Christe, Domine Deus Agnus Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, qui tollis peccata mundi, suscipe deprecationem nostram, qui sedes ad exterram patris, miserere nobis, quoniam tu solus sanctus, Sanctus solus Dominus, tu solus altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum sancto spiritu, in gloria Dei Patris. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole of creation, set free from slavery, may render to your majesty service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep, as a shepherd tends his flock when he finds himself among his scattered sheep, so will I tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered when it was cloudy and dark. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out, the strayed I will bring back, the injured I will bind up, the sick I will heal, but the sleek and the strong I will destroy, shepherding them rightly. As for you, my sheep, says the Lord God, I will judge between one sheep and another, between rams and goats. The word of the Lord. A responsorial psalm, the response is, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life. But each one in proper order, Christ the firstfruits, then at his coming those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. When everything is subjected to him, then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who subjected everything to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all his angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you are blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the very foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me.' And then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, amen, I say unto you, whatsoever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me.' And then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison, and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison and not minister to your needs?' He will answer them, 'Amen, amen, I say unto you, whatsoever you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to everlasting life." The Gospel of the Lord. Most of us who have reached a certain level of age and experience remember a film that came out in 1956, that's a ways back. It was called The King and I, starring Deborah Kerr and Yul Brynner. How many of you remember that movie? It was lingered for quite a while. My goodness. Either you're seeing a lot of reruns or we need to get the average age of St. Raphael down a little bit. My goodness. The movie is based on a novel derived from a memoir, which became a Broadway Rodgers and Hammerstein musical, which became the movie which became in 1999 an animated cartoon-type film. Deborah Kerr starred as an English schoolteacher who was hired for The Children of a King, while Yul Brynner appeared as the King of Thailand, an absolute 19th century monarch who eventually crumpled before the wit, charms, and wisdom of the ever-lovely teacher. Brynner played King Mongkut, a ruler imperious in demeanor, impervious to pleas and petitions, and impenetrable to examination. And yet, much as one might expect, Kerr, as Anna Leon Owens, managed to soften his heart and win education and a little freedom for her students, and maybe even a little romance for herself. While The King and I is loosely based on the work and relationships of a British schoolteacher in the Siamese court, it is largely fanciful. Not so the royal court of today's Thailand, an important Southeast Asian ally of the United States. For the past 2 years, ever since the death of King Bhumibol Adulyadej IV, a much beloved monarch and chief of state who stood up for democracy, freedom, and opportunity, the Thai people have had some trouble warming to his son, King Maha Vajiralongkorn. These Thai names would tie your tongue into. Vajiralongkorn is something of a playboy, a cad, and a ne'er-do-well. I'm not saying the king is an evil man. Compared to many prime ministers, presidents, and leaders in our world, all allegedly elected in democratic fashion, he's not so bad. Interestingly enough, for me, years ago, his father, King Bhumibol, who went by the regnal name of Rama IX, came to the airport at home in North Adams. He had students to visit who were pursuing graduate degrees in development economics at nearby Williams College, and the nuns in our school urged us all to go out to greet the king and waved him, so we did, and I've been bragging about it ever since. And he went back, was that fast. But I always paid attention to him, and he turned out to be a remarkably good man. The new king, whose regnal name is Rama X, thank goodness for regnal names, because to have to say Maha Vajiralongkorn a lot would really be a workout. Rama X is a university graduate, the University of New South Wales, trained at the Royal Military College in Australia, qualified as a jet fighter pilot, served briefly in a Buddhist monastery that lasted all of 15 days, joined the Thai military, and is interested in better agriculture, rural healthcare, and university education. So it's clear he does care about his people. Until he ascended the throne last year, however, he spent most of his time out of the country. He's known to like a good time, that can be defined in ways that are perhaps a bit troubling, relaxation and comfort. And he has let Thailand's generals run roughshod over political and human rights. During the past 2 months, massive street demonstrations, arrests, and strikes have called for the modernization of the monarchy and the strengthening of basic freedoms and rights. Because of the COVIDium, which began, as you know, back in March, for us anyway, Vajiralongkorn has spent much of this year in an alpine resort in Bavaria, managing to annoy both the German government and the Thai people. By the way, if you think President Trump is a wealthy fellow, and he is, I guess, you might want to check out King Rama X. He's worth personally, not the throne, but himself, worth a cool $30 billion. I'm glad I waved to his father, but apparently I didn't wave enough. Our concern here is neither to criticize the Thai king nor his people. I wish them well. Thailand has been a good friend to the United States, and please God, their traditions and their freedoms will be preserved with good sense all around. But we might profitably notice the complexity of monarchy, democracy, economy, and personal choice. And by the way, those four words all matter to you and to me as Catholics and actually as Americans as well. Together, we can make a witch's brew of difficulty if our priorities are not just and secure. The king we celebrate today, of course, is Jesus of Nazareth. a king of an entirely different kind, a different order of being, and a different purpose from any earthly ruler. On this solemnity of Christ the King, it is easy to see the vast difference between earthly and heavenly rulers. Jesus, the crucified and risen one, is in the game for the long term. His priorities are always personal, which is to say they're always about you and me, and they are long-lasting beyond words, for they are eternal. He wants to give each one of us the grace of divine life so that we might be led to happiness eternally. He shows us that not only does our salvation cost him his earthly life, but that it will demand sacrifices from us too. The cross is inescapable, but it is always worth it. Always it gives life. In fact, the cross is the throne from which Jesus Christ, King of the universe, reigns forever. We must show love for God and each other, and love is inseparable from sacrifice. Sacrifice demands that I give up and hand over for the good of another. Throughout the scriptural readings this morning, we see the image of sheep in need of a shepherd. The shepherd can only profit when the sheep are safe, refreshed, and well nourished. It can only rest when they are where they should be. The shepherd is prepared even to die to defend them. When we stray, he searches for us and calls us home. He risks everything to reach out to us. When we are hurt, disappointed, rejected, scorned, or abandoned, he smiles at us, reminding each man and woman that he knows our pain and he will take our suffering into himself and transform it into life for us. He knows us, his sheep, each one by name. He has held us as lambs, and so he knows us. As the ancient Irish hymn declares, "The King of love, my shepherd is." As a king, however, the Lord Jesus is not simply a servant, powerful and impressive in his condescension, humility, and depth of love. Jesus is also a reigning and ruling king, and as such has the power and right to instruct and command. In our gospel from Matthew 25, we discover what that final command means. When Jesus, at the vision of the coming of the Son of Man in glory, declares, "Whatsoever you did for one of these least of my brothers and sisters, you did for me. And whatsoever you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me." We discover what the stakes of the game of life, are. The final judgment scene, where the king separates those who have endeavored to love their neighbor and care for them from those who selfishly look only to their own needs, wants, and desires, mirrors the way a shepherd separates sheep from goats. If ever we wish to hear the Lord say to us, "Come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for ye from the very foundation of the world," we must feed the hungry, refresh the thirsty, welcome the stranger, clothe the naked, care for the sick, and visit the imprisoned, and we must do it now. It is important for us to remember, too, that the work of our redemption was done by Jesus on the cross. What we do here is not win our redemption, but respond to his grace as we care for our neighbor. Our faith, my friends, is many things: trust in God, knowledge of Christ, understanding of Scripture, beauty in worship, depth in prayer, cleansing and new life in baptism, nourishment and refreshment in the Eucharist, healing in reconciliation and all the other sacraments, moral discernment and choices. But Catholic faith is always and everywhere love expressed in respect and justice, mercy and care. We fail from that standard so often, and yet it is the standard of Christ-like love. And if we leave that dimension of faith aside and stress only one or another of the ones I first mentioned, how impoverished we leave our faith, how much our faith lacks, because it lacks the love that is the heart of Christ and the heart of God himself. I hope you're not as addicted to YouTube as I became. I've gotten over it, but it's a fascinating thing. Every band you wanted to hear, every historical film, I always watch just the historical films, please remember that. If you miss something on Saturday Night Live, whatever, if you want to hear somebody's political talk, whatever it might be. There's a new video making the rounds these days about a young fellow, a new pastor assigned to a well-to-do parish, perhaps a Catholic church. The newly named pastor arrived in disguise on his first Sunday on duty. He looked like a homeless bum, to be crass. Long hair, boots in disrepair, ripped jeans, and a ratty old campaign jacket. Father Patrick on his worst day, Father Jerome on his worst day, couldn't look any worse than this guy. He greeted people at the door and tried to enter, but was discouraged. He persisted, and finally an usher showed him to a seat in the back, behind a pillar. Nobody could see him. And yet, people kept turning, trying to look and stare. There were a few sneers in the bargain. Only the deacon of the service, which was celebrated by another priest, knew who the vagrant truly was. And finally, during the announcement, the bum went up to the pulpit. There were people who were ready to jump up to prevent any harm. The deacon stepped aside, and the new pastor stepped into the pulpit and introduced himself. And yet he only made a vague reference to the way he was spurned. He greeted the people, wished them well in the Lord Jesus, and told them when he would be fully on duty. Suddenly, there was a lot of gulping, blushing, and head shaking, and weeping. The people of that parish got it, but a little bit late, wouldn't you say? Jesus says, "Whatsoever you do for the least of my brothers and sisters, that you do unto me." God bless you. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, a light from light, a true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In a spirit of confidence and hope now, let us present our petitions before God's most holy throne.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the whole state of the Church, that all her sons and daughters may recognize the sovereignty of Christ over their lives and welcome him into their hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for each one here present, for all our loved ones, that we acknowledge Christ as our King, honor him by our participation in Mass, and welcome him by responding generously to the needs of our brothers and sisters, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that the Church may enjoy freedom, justice, and respect throughout the world, and that every nation will respect human rights, including the rights to worship, conscience, expression, and assembly. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this weekend, as we note the feast of Saint Cecilia, patroness of music today, we pray for all those engaged in music ministry here at St. Raphael. We ask God's special blessing on our choir director, organists, choir members, and cantors, as we thank them for their generous gift of time and talent in our worship each week. May the Lord bless them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For Abbot Mark and the monks of St. Anselm Abbey, Father Jerome and the members of St. Raphael Parish community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who serve in the military and all who defend our country, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's comfort and healing to those who are sick, whose names are listed on our prayer line, and for those who have died, especially Reverend Adrian Longchamps, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a deeper understanding among those discerning their vocation, that the one who calls them is Jesus Christ the King, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own intentions. For these intentions, and for our parish family for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God our Father, source of all that is good in our lives, we thank you for the many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. In your mercy, you sent us your own Son, your only begotten Son, the second person of the Blessed Trinity, who condescended to become man like us. We depict him now as King of Glory with a crown of gold and jewels, and yet he won for us salvation. He redeemed us from sin and death with a crown of thorns. Help us to open our hearts to his presence, and help that presence stimulate us always to love our brothers and sisters, modeling our love on the great love he has for each of us. We make this prayer, as always, through Christ our Lord. Before we move to our offertory, a reminder that this is the day when we bless our choir. We don't have our choir. We have a cantrix with us upstairs, as well as Lyle, our organist. I would ask them to rise for their blessing. And if we have any members of the choir, any members who would like to become members of the choir, you may stand as well, and I shall impose the blessing on you. Any choir members out there? Well, isn't that pathetic for the 9:30 Mass? See what you can do about that, okay? You're all blessed with there are some people we'll pay not to sing, but you have to be identified privately. But there are many possible singers. This is the second time Lyle has received the blessing. Does this, just today, does this mean you're in greater need of it, or what? I forget that he can silence me pretty easily. God our Father, we ask you to look down upon these men and women, those who raise up their voices and use their talents to give glory to you and help lead us in worship. Bless them, bless their loved ones and families, and bless the work that they do among us. We ask this now and always, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Lift high the cross,
Ovidium, there's no procession. Set that stuff down because they have to incense too. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we offer you, O Lord our God, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness, as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your divine majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mysterium Fidei.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Holy Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her beloved spouse, with John the Baptist, with Peter and Paul and all the blessed apostles, with Saint Cecilia and all the glorious martyrs, with your holy ones, Benedict, Scholastica, and Anselm, with the great Archangel Raphael, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Peter our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. On this day, we remember in a special way the deceased members of St. Raphael Parish, as well as our deceased pastors and curates, and the deceased among our own families, circles of friends, and communities of faith. There, in that kingdom, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Per ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso est ibi Deo Patri omnipotenti, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honor et gloria per omnia saecula saeculorum.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, and behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Given the increase in infections and the governor's reassertion and expansion of guidelines, just a reminder, please make sure you have your mask on as you come up. Make sure that it is worn correctly over both nose and mouth. We ask that you receive the sacred host in the palm of your hand and, excuse me, keep your mask on, take a step to the left or right after you have received that host and receive it, remove the mask, return to your seat by way of the side aisles. Positions to receive communion first.
And we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body in His own Lord.
The body of Christ. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. May God bless you, keep in His love now and forever, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May God bless you, keep in His love now and forever, Father, Son, and Spirit, the body of Christ. May God bless you, keep in His love now and forever, the body of Christ.
One bread, one body.
God bless you, keep in His love now and forever, the body of Christ.
Lord of all, one cup of
the body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May God bless you, keep in His love now forever, the body of Christ. May God bless you, keep in His
love forever,
the body of Christ. God bless you, keep in His love now and forever, Father, Son, and Spirit. The body of Christ. 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 Oh no, come, 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 come. Right here, stand in front of me. May God bless you, keeping his love now and forever, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Now you can go. May God bless you, keeping his love now and forever, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. May God bless you, keeping his love now and forever, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. She's so devout. May God bless you, keeping his love now and forever, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Corps du Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Before we move to the conclusion of Holy Mass, a couple of announcements, please. First item is that in terms of the schedule for this coming week, obviously we'll be celebrating the National Festival of Thanksgiving, and we wish you all a very happy and joyful, blessed Thanksgiving. certainly encourage those of you who do not have to travel to avoid it. As you well know, the problem of the surge in infection is pervasive now throughout the country and is quite difficult. So please be careful. Second item is that the Mass for the Vigil of Thanksgiving, our annual gathering in honor of that, will be on Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. here at St. Raphael. Those who often join us at the Abbey, unfortunately this year will be unable to do so. The mighty gates of St. Anselm have closed. Unless you're in the St. Anselm bubble, they are not opening the gates for that. So the Mass to join is the 6:30 here at St. Raphael. We'd be very happy to celebrate with you, and obviously you want to be careful and observe all of the protocols that we've been asked to follow. In terms of other news, our religious education program, as you may know, if you have children or grandchildren, has now gone to remote until after the new year. We'll see what happens. We are governed to some large extent by the policies of the Manchester school system, and they have gone to fully remote. That's where your kids are going to school, I presume, if they're not coming to the Catholic school here or elsewhere. So it will be a remote situation, but they will receive their lessons and they are expected to do their work. Duty, now to perform and substitute themselves for nothing except their duty. I hope that is clear. And the parents are encouraged to do the instruction with them. That is your responsibility. You may have heard in the last week or the last month, certainly, some discussion of the so-called McCarrick Report. It is not a happy thing for the church. Former Cardinal McCarrick of Washington is at the center of the scandal, the abuse scandal, and that sad issue was addressed in my column this week, so you might like to read that, not like it, but certainly find it necessary and useful. Last item is that you will find at the information nook, we have some people, I don't know if I can see them, are they there? They're making a half-hearted effort to wave at me. One of them is, the other one, finally, they now get the idea. They will be there to assist you if you'd like to purchase the finest gift calendar, the finest prize calendar in Northern New England, indeed in the Northern Hemisphere. So buy it. 64, can you stand it? 64 opportunities to win something wonderful and enrich your life. I mean, unless you want to get a complete collection of my homilies, which would be far more valuable to you, of course, but those are not yet ready, but the calendar is. So I encourage you to do that. And we also are trying to sell a lot of them, just so you know, we appreciate your buying of a one calendar for yourself, but please remember, we are all asked to become salesmen for this. We have no fundraisers this year whatsoever except this one. So unless you're planning to make a multi-$100,000 gift to St. Raphael before the end of the year, we need everybody to get up, get out, and get selling. So there you have it. Please rise. Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord our God, that glorying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever. We ask you to keep your kneelers in the down position. If you're planning to speak to the calendar desk, please maintain social distance, and otherwise have a wonderful week and a blessed Thanksgiving. By the way, that cleaning crew could use a little help if you've got the time. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go and give glory to God by the manner of your lives.
Thank you, guys. Great job.